Welcome to Ballroom U's Living Room Waltz. I'm Ian, and this is Whitney. And throughout this series, we're going to teach you how to waltz in your living room. We start off with the first part of the series, showing you the core grouping. In the following parts, we're going to take that core grouping and stylize each move a little bit more each time. In this video, we'll start off by going over the leads part, then we'll talk about the follows part, and then we'll work it together. All the while, we'll explain what's going on in each segment. If you need a further breakdown, we'll have a beginner's guide where we go over each move individually on a deeper level, separate from this video. If you're already familiar with waltz, you can skip to the end where Whitney and I go over the whole grouping very quickly with a few tips here and there, and that'll get you started and ready for parts 2 and 3.
Her name, and I sing my lion song and brush my mane. She would, and she could, so she pulled my lion's tail and caused me pain.
We're going to break down our living room waltz into 3 chunks. The first piece will be our boxes, the second piece will be our twinkle and whisks, and then the third piece will be the underarm turn and hesitation. So I'm just going to quickly overview these chunks. Then after this, we're going to go down into breaking down the footwork for the lead and follow. And then after that, I'll give you some just extra tips on how you can use this and mix it up. So starting with your left foot, guys, we're just going to do a left box. So we'll do our left box that rotates naturally to the left, or reversely. And then when we want to switch, we'll do our left box just the first half and switch to the right box. And then we'll do the right box. We'll do one more half a box forward. And then we'll go into our twinkle. So that's part 2. Now part 2, we'll start again with the left foot and we'll do our twinkle. From here, we'll finish it up and go back with our left foot. In my opinion, this is the trickiest part, but it also makes it stay on a small space here. So we're gonna go back with the left foot, then we'll go side, rock, step, side, rock, step, side, rock, step. And from here, we're gonna do what we call in the studio a swoosh, but we're gonna bring her in front of us as we step forward on 1. So rock, step, 1, 2, 3. Now this is the last part, the underarm turn and the hesitation. We're going to go immediately into that underarm turn by releasing the right side and picking her up, finish the box, and then we'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now I'm going to do the whole thing with counts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Piece 2, starting with the twinkle with counts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now the last piece with counts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And that's the leads part with counts. So now we're going to talk about some lead and follow and some extra tips on how to use this in your living room. So to start off with, just part 1, we're going to start with the low frame. So the low frame is important because this is going to be too big. So we're still going to be offset, but I'm going to wrap around kind of like a rumble hold, but closer. So instead of connecting here, I'm going to connect closer to my elbow. Now everyone fits together a little bit differently, but the idea is that I want to have my fingers pointing toward her lower back. So up here is going to look uncomfortable, so just wrap around this way. And for the ladies, you're going to wrap around just like rumba right here. Now the reason that we can have this type of hold is because we're actually closer. So even body contact is fine, but you just want to make sure that you're offset. Now from here, I'm going to take this hand, and you can hold it low. You could hold it in a swing hold. You could just hold it right here. But the idea is you want to be smaller. I like to hold it lower. So we're going to start with our left box now. So we'll do our left box. So we'll go forward, side, together, and then rotate on the back half. Then we'll do another half a box so that we can switch into the right. So anytime you want to switch from a left box to a right box, we're going to use a half a box, forward half a box, to link. So I just did a forward half a box. Now I'm going to do another forward half a box to get into the right box. One, two, three. Now from here, I'm going to go back on my left foot, back, side, together. And then I'm going to do another forward half a box so I can link into the next part, forward half a box. Now for part two, we're going to start with the twinkle. So the twinkle, we want to make sure that we go forward. And this side step, we're going to start to rotate into promenade and then close our feet. Then from here, we'll step through and close. Now we're going to go back with the left foot as we bring her around and keep that momentum moving to the side so we can rock step. And you see I open my body up a little bit, and we'll do that from a different angle, as I go to the side so that she knows to rock step. And then the same here. So I'm kind of letting her take that rock step. Because otherwise, you'll bring her with you. So if I start here, if I go to my angle, that's bringing her with you, which is a different thing. So we're rocking back here, rocking back. Now I'm going to close her to my new angle. Then from here, I'll go off to the side and immediately start that underarm turn. So I'll just lower my hand. Watch your arm styling so you don't knock anything off your shelves, right? So nice low arm there. And then after I gather her back up, I'll just do our hesitation, which I'm going to kind of scoop into. One, two, three. So I kind of think about it like a quarter pipe almost. So I'm a little bit low to start off with, and I just step into it and come up, and then I scoop back out.
So we're going to be going over the followers part for the Waltz series. As a follower, we're going to start with our right foot, and we're going to move back with a left box turn. One, two, three, four, five, six, gentle rotation over the left shoulder. From here, we're going to do half a box with our right foot to segue into the right turning box. This time, our left foot's going to move back as we rotate over the right shoulder, move underneath our partner, and finish with a back half a box. At this point, we're going to do one twinkle. We're going to move back, side, close our feet into promenade, and then forward half a box. From here, we're going to do one more right turning box where we step forward under our partner's body, off to the side into some whisks. We'll do three, turning into promenade and counter promenade on each rock step. We're going to do a small pivot over our left shoulder as we move back into half a box, back, side, together, where we'll move into now an underarm turn to the right. Four, five, six, and then we'll close one, two, three, and finish the box, four, five, six. We're going to hesitate with our right foot moving backward with a gentle rotation of the upper body. One, two, three, then a half a box, four, five, six. So we're going to go over a few tips for the follow, just to walk you through this grouping to let you know exactly where you are and where we're changing weight and about how much rotation we're going to be doing. So as we start, Ian was mentioning about the frame, how it's a little more casual. So we are going to keep our arm wrapped around wherever your partner or your non-partner is. It's going to be a little more relaxed here. As we're doing this frame, we can also keep our right side a little bit lower. And in waltz, typically we have our head off to the left. But we're actually, you can keep your head right in front, or you can even look down towards your right hand. A little more reminiscent of Argentine tango, because it is a little more intimate, this style of waltz. So we want to make sure that we always start with our right foot. That way, whichever direction our partner is leading us to rotate, we at least are on the correct foot. So we're going to do a forward half a box, which from our perspective is actually a back half a box. So we're going to take our right foot and move back, side, together, and then make sure we're changing weight completely at every corner of the box so that now we can rotate over the left shoulder gently. From here, we have what we call a little bridge so that we can bridge our way from left rotation to right rotation as we do half a box.
And then take that left foot back this time to allow our partner to come around us, which will initiate rotation to the right. At this point, my right foot is going to be free, and I'm going to swing that leg right under my partner and then move off to the side and close my feet, changing weight. One more half a box so that then we can move into our twinkle. Your twinkle is going to be a box step that ends in promenade on the third count. So I'm going to step back, I'm going to go off to the side and swivel a tiny bit as I close my feet and rotate into promenade, which is where we're both just looking in the same direction. From here, we're going to move forward and side together, closing our feet, changing weight. We have one more right turning box here as we step under our partner, off to the side and close our feet before we move a step to the side with our left to begin whisk. So we'll take that right foot and rock step back, rotating into promenade, moving off to the side, rotating into counter promenade and rocking with the left foot. And one more time as we do that with the right foot. At this point, our lead is going to bring us back in front of him. And the way he's going to do that is by swiveling us off of that last step we took before we step back with the right, off to the side, closing our feet, changing weight. Our left foot is free. And at this point, we're going to enter an underarm turn. So we're going to step, two, three, four forward steps and a side together before we complete this back half a box and enter a hesitation. So we're going to move back with the right foot and hold for two beats. And then finish four, five, six with our left foot. And your right foot is free to begin again. And that's the follows part. For the follow, at the very end, we have a hesitation. We have a tiny bit of styling that we can add as well. So as we step into this hesitation, we're gonna get nice and grounded over that right foot. And as we start to rise, we can twist our head to the left just a little bit before we move forward to finish that box. So one more time, we get over that foot, slight twist. We don't want to rotate away from our partner. We just want to tilt our head to the left a little bit and then move right back into our partner's space.
All right, so now we're going to summarize the entire grouping for you. We're going to go from top to bottom and just tandem teach you the entire series so that you guys can both move together as we get you through the grouping. All right, so we're going to begin from the top with a left box turn. Leads are going to do a forward half a box. Follows, we're going to do a back half a box. One, two, three, and rotate on this back half of box here. Leads starting with the right, ladies with the left. Four, five, six. Those six counts reset you. So as the follow, your right foot's free, and as the lead, your left foot's free. At this point, we're going to start our right box turn. In order to transition to that right box turn, we do have to do a full forward change step. So leads with the left, follows with the right. One, two, three. To start rotating over the right shoulder, we're both gonna continue moving in the same direction. So leads, you're gonna step forward with that right foot. As follows, we step back with that left foot, and this will allow you to rotate over that right shoulder. We're gonna continue that rotation as we step forward under his body, follow with the right foot, and leads, as we take a diagonal step back with that left foot on count one. One, two, three, so just a change step there to now have our count four step ready. So ladies, left foot, leads, right foot, four, five, six, rotating over that right shoulder. At this point, we're back on a count one, and we're gonna move into our twinkle. So your twinkle is just a half box with a tiny swivel at the end. So we're gonna do a forward change step, one, to the side, two, swiveling and closing on three into promenade. We're both now moving in the same direction. So we're gonna take the inside leg, follows, this is gonna be our left leg, and leads, this is gonna be your right leg. And we're gonna do another forward change step as we move through four, five, six, closing back to one another. From here, we're gonna move into a right box turn. So if we remember from just a moment ago, we're gonna take that right foot follow and left foot leads and move over the right shoulder. So back for the lead, forward for the follow, forward, side, together, completing that change step. And now we're prepared to move off to the side. So lead, you're gonna take a side step with that right foot. As follows, we take a side step with the left foot and we both do rock steps, mirroring each other. We're gonna do another on this side, rock, step. One last one, rock, step. We've returned to a one count. So leads, you are actually going to swivel your partner back in front of you. So you're gonna bring your frame back in front of you on count one as you move into a box step. Follows, we're gonna swivel and step back on one, off to the side, two, closing our feet and changing weight on counts three, because that's just a normal half a box after a little swivel there.
leads, you're going to open up your right arm. As we step back and do a half box, as your lady walks under the arm for three counts. So we're going to back that up. Our left foot is free follow, right foot free for the lead. So we're going to move 4, 5, 6. At this point, we're going to do a forward half of a box, meeting each other up in the center. Forward, side, together. And we're back on count 4, and we're going to finish the box step here. So leads, you're going to step back to invite your partner to you. And ladies, we're going to step forward, side, together. Now we have our hesitation. So we're going to move forward, leads with the left foot, and follows back on the right foot, and hold for 2 beats, collecting the leg under the body, but not changing weight. That's what makes this a hesitation. And then rotate on the back half of the box, 4, 5, 6. And you can repeat from the very beginning now.
Thanks for joining us for our Level 1 Living Room Waltz Series. We hope you enjoyed this series and can't wait for you to check out Level 2 and Level 3, where we'll transform these patterns into even showier dance moves that you can still use in the comfort of your own home. If you have any questions about the individual patterns themselves, be sure to refer to our Beginner's Guide to Living Room Waltz. This is a crash course on all of the patterns that will be introduced to you during our Level 1 Living Room Waltz series.